Hey, it's Graham, Managing Director at BuddyBoss, here with our first product update of 2024. In this new format, I'll be reviewing what's happening at BuddyBoss so far this year, and I'll then show you four updates releasing tomorrow. Then finally, we'll discuss the vision of BuddyBoss through April to June. Unlike our previous BuddyBoss updates, I'm not going to go into depth across the rest of BuddyBoss. This video going forward is solely focused on our product. So do let me know if you enjoy this format in the comment section below. 2023 was a transformative year for the product team at BuddyBoss. We released 23 features, over 300 enhancements, and squashed over 2,000 bugs. And we finished the year by releasing the long-awaited Tutor LMS integration and had a really good amount of features on the activity feed released as well. Going into January this year, we were determined to keep up the momentum that we'd gained and were finally ready to release reactions. It was greatly received by many of you because not only could you pick and choose your preferred emotion, but you could even upload your very own custom one. And it's great to see how many communities with their unique flair came to use these custom emotions. Our app team during this time also worked on the blog redesign, providing a much cleaner reading experience, as well as adding native sharing and the recommended post blocks to keep your readers engaged post after post. As we moved into February, we released the user initials for groups and profiles, providing more options for customers who wanted more than just a default avatar across their groups or profiles. Our app team also went further with that native sharing capability to provide the app share link, a way to allow your users to invite their friends and contacts through that same native sharing functionality that we use in the blog redesign. This time though, you had the added element that you can also add a thumbnail and a description, which would then link to the appropriate app store depending on the device. Our sister company Rapyd also launched in February. Rapyd is a high performance managed hosting solution built from the ground up for BuddyBoss and other dynamic sites. Born out of necessity, it has been a growing trend for several years now that customers just couldn't find the hosting that provided a great user experience with both the scalability and the configuration to suit dynamic content. Either they reduced PHP workers to a minimum, or they cached so hard that communities never truly felt alive. Well, that's no more. Go check out the fastest cloud hosting solution built purposely for your needs on rapyd.cloud. And right now we do have the early bird discount, but this will be closing in a couple of weeks, so don't miss out. With Rapyd launch, we now hit March and we released our Google Recapture integration aimed at reducing spam registrations. Now I know many of you have mentioned Cloudflare's turnstile since, and we're not ignoring that feedback, but the statistics right now still show that Google Capture is the majority player in this space. But we'll look to see if we can support turnstile in the future. There are still some outstanding areas to work on with the recapture, specifically around our API registrations and the app captures. And we're currently exploring both of these solutions to be provided in the near future. Outside of all these features, we've also released another 46 enhancements. Now these include database improvements and refactoring, Google font dependency issues, updates to our app code-based libraries. We had some compatibility updates for the Learn-4.10. We added object caching support on some of the news feed, and we had a whole bunch of general performance improvements. And that brings us to the present, April, and boy, do I have a lot to share. Firstly, we launched a webinar in collaboration with Femium, and we pre-launched the BuddyBoss app for Tutor LMS. It was clear when we launched the web integration that many of our customers and the Tutor LMS community really wanted a native app. So our team have been working extremely hard with the Femium team in order to have this ready, and it should be ready in only a matter of weeks now. The new app takes everything that we've built upon since the launch of the BuddyBoss app and extends the full APIs to include Tutor LMS, making it a perfect solution for those customers looking for a mobile solution. If you're using Tutor LMS or you're considering it for your LMS right now, take a look at our online demo and keep your eyes peeled for our app demo coming very soon. Next up, we have four new features on the way, and they're releasing tomorrow. That's three new functionalities, one huge performance improvement, and a UI update. Let's go check it out. We've made big visual improvements to the activity posts. Starting with the post section, we've now moved like and comment action buttons to the center, providing a more modern look and feel. Comments and replies are also now separated, rather than being all blocked together. And we've applied visual lines to make threaded replies easier to read. You will also now notice the write a comment section at the bottom also automatically shows and has had a facelift. It's now showing it all in line and looks a lot more sleek as part of this update. Of course, these updates also apply to the app. So I hope you feel the same when I say it's a big improvement from our previous appearance. The keen-eyed of you may have noticed that this new notification bell on the top right of the post. And that's because you can now unsubscribe from individual posts. From the ellipsis at the top, you'll now be able to opt in and out of notifications, allowing you to reduce notifications on posts that you're no longer interested in. And if a post is no longer of value, or perhaps it needs cooling off a bit, we've now provided the ability for users and site administrators to completely close comments on their posts. This also extends to your groups to allow your administrators more control over their active conversations. Up next, we're now allowing you to decide how many comments and replies are going to be shown on posts before a View More button is shown. By reducing the amount of comments shown by default, it's going to reduce the load time as well as keep your activity feed cleaner for those of your users who are scrolling through your most recent posts. From this update, when you do click on the View Reply or on the Comments button, we're now going to load comments in a modal. It's essentially the same principle that's applied across many other social network platforms. By using this approach, it's going to keep the attention focused on the post itself and provides a much better user experience when it comes to reading through long and lengthy comments. It also opens up the future development plans as we intend to add comment filters such as order by latest or most popular comments in the future. And if somehow you didn't notice the visual improvements, you should notice loading times have been reduced on every BuddyBoss related page. In this update, we have halved the amount of page requests from 4 down to 2. And you'll also have the ability to reduce that option down to a single page request. Massive. Not only that, you can now define how many activity posts are going to be loaded on each page request. Now, this was previously hard-coded to 20, which was seen as excessive for most communities. Well, now you're going to be able to decrease this to 5 or 10 posts. And by doing this, it's going to further improve your page speed performance. Both of these settings are now going to be available under the new performance tab, which is where you can tweak some of the under the hood logic to fine tune your experience. We're going to be using this section now to future house other settings that generally need either further testing or are really dependent on your site resources. And this is where email throttling will also be located in a future update. Now, our roadmap has looked a little quiet recently, and that's because we're changing how much we share with you in advance. This ensures we're a little bit more accurate with timelines, and we also live up to your expectations. Early this month, we're going to be cleaning up and updating our roadmap, so it's now typically only going to focus on a quarter at a time, and you'll be able to see regular movement of our cards if our plans change. That said, please do continue sharing your feedback, as we always begin looking at all the feedback over any features that we're looking to either build new or enhance existing over the next 3 to 6 months. And we always take your feedback into consideration. During this quarter, we will of course be releasing the BuddyBoss app for Tutor LMS. As I previously mentioned, it's going to be just available in a few weeks now. We are currently offering a pre-launch discount, so if this is something you're looking for, not only can you register now for a discount, but we're also going to be providing exclusive workshops to help you build your app and publish it on the App Store in days. Descriptions will be available in the link below. Up next, site owners and group owners are going to get the ability to schedule posts, allowing you to prepare your content in activity feeds or groups in advance. This is going to be a fantastic solution for those e-learning communities who wish to schedule weekly check-ins or challenges across all their course groups. We're also planning to release polls this quarter. And again, this is going to start by being limited to both site owners and group moderators. But we're really keen to get your feedback whether you'd like this to be available to all users in the future. Now, with all these features coming, one which has been sitting on the bench is the notification digests, which is also going to be resolved this quarter. Mass notifications has always been a problem of BuddyBoss since its release in 2019. But with our group subscription feature, it's really accelerated that issue for any active communities with large engagements. And so we really are determined to find a suitable experience where we can fine tune how many notifications are sent while still allowing you to use custom email templates when they are applied. Now, as I mentioned before, we are working on email throttling, which is also coming under this same banner, as it's going to be a solution that partially solves the problem. We also have some exciting features coming to the app. Very shortly, you'll be able to customize your app navigation bar with two more additional buttons. Or you could even move your more menu to the header, and then you're going to gain a new slot or available slot on the tab bar. This was one of the biggest requests for the app. And with our libraries now updated, we're in a position that we can provide more customization to your app, which is one of the biggest goals this quarter. We're currently redesigning the group screen to incorporate the menu into the group header. This will allow you to go directly to the feed as soon as you click the group from the directory screen, an enhancement that is long overdue. I'm really going to be excited to see this improve your user's experience right now. And I know we're also looking across the rest of the app to start doing other enhancements to improve your user's experience. Our goal on the app development is to focus on customization without the need of custom development. And as I mentioned, we're starting with the navigation bar. We'll then be moving on to custom post types and the universal post block, which will include carousels, grids, lists, and a lot more as time goes on. We've got huge plans for the app this year, and I really intend to make the app a must-have purchase for any online community or e-learning site. If you're not already aware, mobile learning is still growing by 30% year on year, currently worth at $70 billion. And 80% of us, myself included, wake up and check our phones within 10 minutes of waking up. So if you're not already thinking about your mobile strategy, you really need to start now. But outside everything I've mentioned today on this video, we still have three more projects on the go that need a little more development before I can tease any details. But rest assured, when I can, this will be the best place to get the news. So if you haven't already, click that subscribe button. Now I want to hear from you. What are your thoughts around the features releasing tomorrow, and what excites you about our roadmap for this next quarter? Do share your comments below, and I can't wait to read through them. Over this week, you're also going to see a lot more tutorials covering all the new features that we're releasing tomorrow in more depth. So with that said, I look forward to seeing you in the comment section, and if not, I'll see you on the next BuddyBoss video.